Hello guys, in this quick video I'm going to show you how to get the adaptive refresh rate if you have Galaxy S20 FE, Galaxy S20 Ultra, S21 FE. These devices doesn't have the adaptive refresh rate. It's either you choose 60Hz or 120Hz. It's only on the recent Galaxy devices that they introduced the adaptive refresh rate, where the screen can dial down to maybe 60 or 40 or 30 when we are not interacting with your screen. So I am using a Galaxy S20 FE and it doesn't have adaptive refresh rate. If I go to my motion smoothness, you're going to see that I have high enabled. It's either you choose high or standard. There's no option for adaptive refresh rate. But I made a video previously about how to enable power saving mode on Galaxy devices. And after enabling power saving mode, you won't lose the high refresh rate, because Samsung won't let you use power save mode and 120Hz. So it's the same software I'm going to use, the same app, Galaxy Max Hz. So there are things you need to do for this app to work perfectly on your device. You need to set up some ADB commands on your PC. So I'm not going to go through that again in this video. If you want to do that, you go back to the video and watch it so that you know what to do. I'm going to put the link in the description of this video. So once you have run everything, just click on adaptive. That's all. That's all you have to do. And this will give you the ability to use adaptive refresh rate. If you scroll down, you're going to see where is the settings. Okay, default refresh rate. Here you're going to set the minimum delay when your screen is going to go back to 60Hz, because it's going to be switching to 120 and 60. You're going to stay at 60 when you are not doing anything. So I set mine to 5 seconds if I am watching a video, maybe on Netflix or YouTube. 5 seconds is going to switch to 60Hz. This will help me save battery. By default it is set by 1.5, but I just choose 5 seconds. You can play around with it if you want. You can also limit your refresh rate while you are typing. So there are so many features with this app. I won't go through all of them, but you can also use 48Hz if your device is screen off on or always on display. So that'll be all for this quick video. If we go back to our settings, go to display, you can see right now that we have adaptive motion smoothness, but before we don't have it. So this is how to get adaptive motion smoothness on pretty much any Galaxy device that doesn't have it. I'm going to show you a quick demo that it works pretty fine for me. You can see it's at 120Hz right now, and if I stop interacting with the screen, it's going to go back to 60Hz. So that's how to do it. That's all for this video. See you guys in the next one. Peace out.